Hey friends, welcome to my channel called AquaBloomBoutique. If you guys are new here, you guys don't know who I am, my name is Zua, or you guys can call me Z if you guys cannot pronounce my name Zua. In today's video, we are going to be learning how to do an applique design on a kids t-shirt using the Brother Entrepreneur pr1050x. This embroidery machine is a 10 needle. It's a home multi-needle. It's not an industrial, but it's able to do what I need it to do. And then in this part, you guys just see me, you know, loading my design onto my USB, so I'm able to take the design and load it onto my embroidery machine. And then the next part, I'm going to be showing you guys how I prepare my shirts. So today I'm using a black t-shirt. Actually, I'm doing it on a black t-shirt because I'm doing my pink design. And so I'm going to use a poly mesh that is not fusible. Normally I use fusible poly mesh, but for a black shirt, I only use the regular poly mesh, and I have to use a spray bottle to spray it so it's a little bit sticky so I can put on the shirt. So I do not spray on the shirt. Do not spray on your shirt, like spray on your stabilizer like how I show you guys in the video, and then just spray the stabilizer onto your shirt so that way your shirt is not sticky or gooey or nasty, you know, because you want it not to be sticky. So you spray directly onto the stabilizer. So you guys see here that I tried to protect my surface. The first one I did not, so in this one I grab a piece of butcher paper, or I think this is not butcher paper, this is just some kind of paper that I have. I use this to do pattern making, so I just, these are cheap paper from Amazon, so I protected my surface and sprayed it, and then now I'm turning my shirt inside out right here, and then just putting it on the back of my shirt. So the reason I use this poly mesh instead of the fusible one, the regular poly mesh instead of the fusible, is because with the black shirt, with the fusible poly mesh, it can leave a little bit of residue. So I only use this on my black shirt. So with the white shirt, it's okay because it's white. You can't really see all these little speckled of residue. But with the black shirt, you can see that. That's why I'm using this and using my spray adhesive. So this is how I prepare my shirt. And then next, I'm going to show you guys how I center my design. So what I do is I fold my shirt in half, and then I would like press it downward, you know, smash it or pound it to make a crease in the middle of my shirt. You see, you guys see here, I just press it down to create an indentation so I can see the center, like a line going to the center of my shirt. And I'm using a chalk marker here with my ruler to mark where the bottom of my neckline is. I normally do like 1 inch or 1 1/4 inch down from the neckline for kids shirt, and then I mark the bottom of it too because I need to center right in the hoop. Like I normally use most of the time I use this infestation to hoop my shirt because this infestation will always help me center my shirt and I don't have to second guess myself. And here you guys see me using a tear away. I use a tear away because with the poly mesh only, it's not really stabilized because it's not really sturdy. It's still like I guess you need to make it sound like a drum and a little bit sturdier. So then I add another layer of stabilizer, which is a tear away, because you don't need another cutaway because your poly mesh is already a cutaway. So you just need a tear away to help it stabilize it more. So all I do is just put another tear away stabilizer onto it. And then I just try to center, you know, the two dots that we create, the top and the bottom. Try to make that line with the two dots on the mighty hoop. So the mighty hoop has two little dots where you can line the mark where you mark the top and bottom. So that's how you know that it will be exactly centered. You don't have to second guess yourself, you guys. If you guys have issue with centering, I suggest you guys get this infestation from Mighty Hoop, and you guys can use a, you know, a erasable pen or you guys can use a water soluble pen or a chalk. If this is black shirt, you guys can chalk the chalk. You can just spray a little bit of water and, you know, dab it to make it disappear at the end. So yeah, I would suggest that because I'm a person that I have a hard time with lining my shirt. So doing this step helped me align my shirt all the time, and I don't have to second guess or, you know, saying like, oh, did I get the center, you know? So I don't have to worry about that. And then here you guys see me taking my USB and loading into my machine. I use this black connector because I do not want my machine to break, because, you know, I always go back and forth like putting a USB through it, so you want to try to avoid that. So instead you buy this connector, so if this connector break, you can just buy a new one, because you don't want to take your USB in and out of your machine and, you know, break the little connector on your machine. So here I just load my design, and then you see here I click the three thread spool to show me where I need to, you know, change my thread. Like wherever you place your thread on the back of your machine, you need to find the color that corresponds to it. So here I'm just finding the color that corresponds to the spool that I put in the back. So I'm just clicking that, and this is how you do your applique. Like there's a little hand where you click the hand to show that you need to stop. So it will stop your machine to help you put your, to let you put your applique fabric onto it, like the fabric for the applique. It will stop that step, and so you can put your fabric onto it to do the applique. So I already fixed all the color correspondent to wherever I lay my thread in the back. So I already did all that. And then here, you know, I just take off my USB, and then I just press one of the button there to move my little arm. And then before I embroider anything, I always put a drop of oil onto my bobbin case, and a drop of oil to all of my needle, because you need to oil it to make it run smoother. So I always oil it before I do any embroidery, and I always oil the bobbin case like probably like after every two shirts, just to keep it oil down there. So yeah, so this take a little bit of time because I'm oiling them. So you guys, after I finish oiling and, you know, hooping my shirt, I will put my shirt onto my machine, on the arm of my machine. And then here you guys see that the design's already loaded. You guys saw me did that earlier. And then I turn on my live camera. The good thing about this machine is it has a live camera and a scanning camera. So with the live camera, you're able to see your design where it's at in place of, you know, where you want to place it. So here, I want to be right under the mark that I mark on the shirt, so I try to move the design a little bit up so it'll be right under the mark that I mark on my shirt. And then here I'm just checking all my four sides. I'm checking the two sides, the top and the bottom, to see if my design is within the hoop, because you do not want to hit the hoop, okay? So you want to make sure your design is right inside of it. So this machine has that live camera where you can do that. It doesn't have a laser, and it does have a scan where it can scan where your machine, where the design will be at, so it doesn't hit the hoop. But I like that live camera just to double check everything. And then my machine here, you guys see that it's already did my placement stitch. So after the placement stitch, you guys will put your fabric over it. So for applique, it will do a placement stitch first, and then it will do a tack down stitch. And before the tack down stitch, you need to put your fabric material, whatever you guys want to applique with, put it over your placement stitch, and then now it's doing the tack down stitch. So right after this tack down stitch, it will do the next placement stitch. And for me, there's a little button on my machine where the arm will come out as far as it can, so I can trim off part of the fabric. I need to trim this off because the pink palette design, the pink palette will go next to the number. So I just need to clear that error off. And here you guys see that, remember you guys need to take off your hidden bond because you do not want to put that little piece of paper onto it because then you cannot adhere it to your shirt. So make sure you take it out. And then now you can see it's doing the next placement stitch. And then with this pink palette, it has a little hole. So you can see that I'm making a little trim because I do not want to use my seam ripper to try to seam rip the little hole and cut it out. So I create that tiny hole so I can just use my scissor to go inside of it and trim out the little hole off of the design. So next part is it's stitching out the placement stitch for the pink swatch. So for the pink swatch, I'm using HTV vinyl, HTV glitter vinyl. So with this, I cut my HTV to size because I don't like to use a big sheet. So I only use a tiny bit of it and I cut it to the size of the placement stitch. So with this, you guys will need like some kind of marker pen or chopstick to hold it down because it's tiny. And then when the machine, when I start to do the tack down, it will lift up the HTV glitter. So you will want some kind of pen or marker to hold it down until it starts stitching, so then it doesn't lift or shift the HTV. So yeah, and if you use HTV, make sure you guys take out the clear coat, the clear sheet that it come with, because you guys don't need that, and make sure you take it off just the same way you will have to take off with the hidden bond that I showed you guys earlier. And then I finish all my applique step and tack down. And so now I'm just take everything off of my machine and using my curved scissor to trim out all the fabric and all the HTV. The issue, you can rip it, but I don't want to rip it because sometimes it could rip off the whole thing. And so I just use my applique scissor to cut everything out. And this applique scissor, I have a link in my description down below. If you guys want to get the same one, you guys can get it from Allstitch or with the link that I provide you guys from Amazon affiliate link. So here you guys just see me trimming it, and make sure you guys turn your hoop instead of you maneuvering your arm around the design. Turning the hoop, it's easier for you guys to cut, and you guys want to cut as close as possible to the line because this is a satin stitch, so you guys can cut close to the stitch line. You guys cannot do this with the pink stitch, but here you guys can do that with satin stitch. That's why I love the satin stitch design. So here you guys see me using a Teflon sheet to cover my design and using my mini Cricut Easy Press to press everything down. You want to do this step to avoid any bubble or puckering. I noticed that a lot of people don't do this step, and people that have issue with the bubbling is because they don't do this step before I do the satin stitch. Because when you do this step, you get rid of any ear pockets, any ear bubble inside of the fabric. So when you do the satin stitch, it doesn't have any of that. And then when you heat press at the end, you don't have any of the ear bubble or ear pockets that will create like crease or wrinkle, you know. And I see a lot of people have issue with that, like in the Facebook group. People always ask about that, so I'm telling you guys that now. So if you guys have that issue, try to get like a mini iron or a mini Cricut Easy Press to adhere everything down, and you know, get all the ear pocket out, so you guys will have a flat, clean look, and so you guys won't have that wrinkly, bubbly issue that, you know, a lot of people have been asking about in the Facebook group. Anyway, for the rest of the video, I just show you guys the full stitch out of this design. I just let you guys see my machine do the whole stitch out. So the good thing about a multi-needle, you guys, is that it's able to stitch out while you guys don't need to babysit it, because you guys don't have to worry about anything getting caught. And if you guys are a mom like me, you guys know that us mom have little ones to take care of. So I would recommend a multi-needle if you guys get into business, and especially if you guys are a mom, because it helps you when you need to go do something for your kids, or if you guys don't have kids, or if you guys have to do like another order that it's not embroidery, like if you guys have tutu to sew, then you guys can go on your machine, sew your tutu, or sew whatever you guys sell, do other tasks while it finish embroidery. So I know a lot of people want to know about this machine, and I promise you guys that I'm gonna schedule a Q&A and we can talk about this machine. I'm not an expert, you guys, so I will do my best to answer you guys and tell you guys about my machine to the best of my ability and my knowledge and my experience. So I'll come on and tell you guys that, and I will do a community tab so you guys can put your question down there so I could look at it ahead and answer those questions for a Q&A and give you guys an overview of my embroidery machine. So if you guys like want to get the same one for your own business, you guys can see what it can do. And there's many machines out there, you guys, but I'm just gonna talk about my machine, my experience with this machine, just to help those that are looking to getting a multi-needle in case they like this machine. Brother is a really good machine. Brother, you guys know Brother, they're really reliable, and they have all other sewing machines too. So like if you guys already own Brother, yeah, you guys know that Brothers are really reliable. But I will, come on just to tell you guys based off of my experience, okay? So look out for that community tab announcement, you guys. And if you guys are new here, you guys found me through like search or from other places, please consider subscribing if you guys like my content or want to follow along my journey. I will be talking about embroidering, sewing here, and Etsy, and business related stuff here. So hit that subscribe button and put on that bell notification to get notice when I put up video or go on live. So anyways, you guys, thank you for coming on here and watching this video tutorial. It's not the best, but hopefully you guys learned something out of this. And if you guys have any questions, leave it down in the comment. And you guys take care, okay? Have a good day, you guys. I will see you guys again. Bye.